Good morning, Riverdale Elementary. A few updates again to share with you guys. Just a reminder, parent-teacher conferences are next Wednesday, October 21st. If you're interested in having a conference with family, please reach out to that classroom teacher and get a time reserved and set up again. Those are going to be in a virtual format this year. Also, another reminder, any families who are 100% remote learning and would like to transfer back into in-person learning, again, you have until October 23rd to make that happen. If that's planned for you guys, the sooner you can let us know, the better. I've already been reaching out to families regarding busing needs and those types of things, and we're trying to get some of those students put into class rosters. Certainly, we'll continue to do our best to have students from the same families attend on the same days. But otherwise, we're probably not going to be able to accommodate many requests for A day or B day just because our class rosters are pretty well set at this point. And we're going to try to keep those balanced and to keep it as safe as possible for our students. Also, many of you have maybe library books from last spring that haven't been turned in yet. I know our librarian, Mrs. Cote, has been sending out letters and reminders to families. So if you've received one of those letters, please do your best to get those books back to us. We still have a large number of books out from the spring. Just a quick update on some academics for you guys as well. The quarter is finishing up here pretty quickly, and we'll be able to send some reports home as far as how your student's doing. But in the meantime, please continue to check teacherees and check with our classroom teachers if you have any questions. One thing that we've been doing this week at the elementary school is benchmark testing our students, which is a reading assessment to determine where they're at in their reading levels. You know, and we've actually been pleasantly surprised with many of our students where they're at. You know, certainly with being out last spring and some of the challenges of attending 2 days a week, you know, some of those small class sizes and some of the different things we're doing here at the elementary seem to be paying dividends. But certainly we're going to continue to evaluate and continue to find new ways to challenge and push our students forward, as well as providing options and opportunities for students who may be struggling. Another thing for you guys, you know, with all the different things going on this school year and all the things we can't do, you know, some ideas and some things that we're planning to do here to have a little bit of fun at the elementary are we're going to have some dress-up days coming up. So next Thursday and Friday, October 22nd and 23rd, we're going to have a black and gold day here at the elementary. The week of Halloween, our kindergarten students are going to do their normal dress-up. But for everybody else, we're going to have a mismatch day to go along with some Halloween activities for our students. Again, we'll send plenty of reminders on these. As well as typically we have a wonderful Veterans Day celebration here at the elementary school, and we're not going to be able to invite our veterans into our building, but we're still going to have a Veterans Wall and do some Veterans Day activities, including that Thursday and Friday, November 12th and 13th, we're going to have a red, white, and blue dress-up day. So a little bit of fun for us here at the elementary school, so I'm excited about that. Again, if you guys ever have any questions or needs, please reach out to your classroom teachers or myself. I hope everybody has a great weekend. Take care, guys.